I'm really excited to, well, I'm excited about all sections of this class, but specifically about the vocabulary as well. So it's great stuff. And what I want to do is really teach you how to master vocabulary. So please watch this video, pay attention. It's really going to improve not only your TOEFL score, but your English mastery. Really take your time with this video. So the first thing I want to do is I want to take you through this reading system and essentially, I'm sorry, vocabulary system and teach you how you want to study vocabulary. The first thing is that you want to study the right vocabulary. So the best way to do that is to make sure that when you guys do TOEFL readings, if you don't have a vocabulary list, highlight the words that you don't know whenever book you use. And that's the best kind of vocabulary list you can build, one that comes specifically from readings and context. The second thing that I want to talk about is that's where this list actually comes from. So we compiled a list of 252 of the most frequently used TOEFL words. And we got them from the readings. We analyzed about 60 readings, did the data analysis, found out the words that really are used often. And those are the words that actually are used in the listening, speaking, and writing as well. So a pretty powerful list right here for you guys to study. So please take advantage of it. The next thing is we want to talk about the right way to study vocabulary because unfortunately, the way that you study most likely is probably the least effective way. So you're wasting time. So we want to change that immediately. The first thing is you want to master the word. You don't just want to have the word in the back of your head and forget it when it comes to test time or the time to use it. So the way that you want to learn it is in context from actual readings. So that's what we've done. We've actually created a program where every single word we teach is taught within an academic reading. So you learn how it's used. Because a lot of times when you memorize words, what's going to happen is when you see the word, it's going to trigger your memory of the definition. And then you're going to think of that definition when you look at the sentence. So it's going to slow you down in your comprehension. And sometimes the word has more than one definition. So if you didn't learn the appropriate one, it might not fit the sentence. By learning the word within the sentence, you see how it's used idiomatically. You see how it's used as an adjective or an adverb, and your brain associates that word with a sentence already. So when you read it in context in a different sentence, it's much better. You know, a lot of research has been done on how to learn vocabulary and how memorization is built. And unfortunately, you know, just looking at a word and repeating it to yourself is probably one of the worst ways to build it. So that's why we really encourage you to either go with our vocab program or when you study your vocabulary, take your vocabulary from TOEFL readings. You highlight the words you don't know, and rather than use a list, go back to that word, that kind of page that you highlighted on, then look at the highlighted words, read the sentence, and then use that to help you remember the definition. Much faster, much easier, more interesting, and more powerful. The other thing is that when most students, when you likely use vocabulary and you try to build it, you're probably not considering the pronunciation, which is actually really, really sad because that means that it's going to be difficult for you to use the word in speech. And when you hear it in speech or in listenings, you're not going to be able to recognize it easily. So what we've done is with each word, we've actually broken it down into syllables. And we've highlighted in bold the syllable that gets the accent. That way you can understand it naturally. Also, at the very bottom here, let me scroll down real quick. We have a recording of a native speaker reading the academic reading so that you get to understand how the word is used in context with respect to pronunciation. So when you hear it, you can actually know, oh, you know, I know that word, you understand it, you'll take better notes, you'll get a better understanding. This is the way you want to learn vocab. The other thing is that though we don't have it here, we have it in the vocab program. But whenever you study, you want to make sure that you actually practice it immediately. So what you're going to do after, let's say you study 7 words, here we have 14, because studies show that you actually learn in groups of 7 best. That's why a telephone number has 7 digits and not 8 in the United States. That's the easiest group of numbers for a person to remember. So we break down 14 vocab words in groups of 7, so it really maximizes your ability to memorize just the natural way that you learn. So make sure you do the same. If you don't use our program, learn in groups of 7, 14 max. If you learn about 21, 28 words a day, usually that's a bit excessive. So you're going to need too much time. It's going to be easy for you to forget. 14 is kind of a magic number. And after you learn it, use it. So right away, practice and just use it. Even if it's ridiculous, doesn't make sense, that's going to trigger your brain to actually recall that word, use it. You're going to build your understanding of it by actually trying to say it. You're going to remember the pronunciation of it, and you're going to create the word. It's really powerful. And right after that, write a couple of sentences using it. So what I mean is, when you learn, let's say, 14 words, like let's say if you did that here, really quickly, just with the speech, maybe you can go to the speaking section, check a question number one, don't time yourself, and just start talking. Just start talking, whatever it is, even nonsense, just using the words randomly. It'll take like 1 or 2 minutes, but it'll be powerfully helpful in your memory. And then right after that, go to writing questions, number two of our list here, you know, the example question we have, and just write an essay and force yourself to use those words. You know, just do it for the sake of the exercise. It's really going to help you, and it's going to improve your score. Because what I've noticed is that students usually have a much larger vocabulary in their head than they do in their speech or their writing. So even though some of these words may be familiar to you, they're not familiar with respect to pronunciation or content use. So I'm really happy with this program. So I know this was kind of a big video, good introduction, but I want you guys to remember one thing. Study vocabulary intelligently. Don't waste your time. It's a little bit tougher to do, but it's going to pay you back many, many fold. So make sure you learn it in context, learn how it's pronounced, use it in speech right away, use it in writing right away. So I encourage you guys, if you need to build your vocab, to register for our system or to come back to this page and study it regularly or to study with this new methodology. If you guys have any questions about this, let us know. Contact us. I'll let you know other tips on how to improve vocab. And if you're interested in registering, just go to About Our TOEFL Products and you'll learn about the vocab systems that we have and how you can learn all 252 in this way. So good luck. Study hard. And let us know if you have any questions.